Well, here we are, Alan, off and running. We love this competition, the Champions Cup. It's the group stage, match day one.
Yeah, the start of what can be a fantastic journey if you put it together and you're over the night. Big day.
Match today is Benfica against Tottenham. Good side they look at the moment. They won away their last game against Stoke City.
Yeah, nice and tight at the back in the 1-0 win. Clean sheets are great, and the strikers can score.
Well, here we are on match day one. It all lies ahead of us in the Champions Cup. Very exciting, as always, especially in this group.
Well, you always get one group of death, and this is it. You look at the quality of teams in this group. Fascinated to see who comes out on top.
This is the team Benfica are going to field today. Alan, he's going to defend with six, isn't he? He's going to have those two holding midfield players and let the other four go and attack when they can.
Yeah, I mean, the two lads in the middle, the two midfielders, are naturally defensive-minded players, Martin, so I don't think they'll naturally get forward too willingly, so... Yeah, it looks a fairly cautious lineup. Look at it.
This is today's Tottenham Hotspur team. Hugo Lloris starts in goal. Kieran Trippier starts with Danny Rose as the fullbacks. Eric Dyer plays alongside Harry Winks in the middle of the park. We'll see how the striking option works with just one up front. Enjoy the game. 2015-2016, Spurs actually finished third in the Premier League. The best finish in the top division since 1963. Could have been even better, couldn't it?
Yeah, it could. I mean, they say the table doesn't lie, but I think on this occasion, maybe it did. Even as an Arsenal man, I'd say Tottenham were the better team during the course of the campaign, but they just fell away at the end.
Jonas. Eduardo Salvia trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Look how quick he reacted.
Here's the chance to get in the cross.
He could lay it off to the supporting player.
Got past his marker.
Doing well to keep the ball.
Looking for Jonas.
Ending with a challenge. Well, you've got to compliment him for trying, but that's well off target. This is the kind of pitch that I think attacking players favour, Alan, don't they?
I think they do, yeah, because it means mistakes from defenders. And a little bit of miscontrol, loss of footing, and you're in.
Kieran Trippier. The ball away from him with the tackle. Out for a throw. Yeah, over the touchline. Kieran Trippier. Here's Winks. There's good progress with this attack. It's Eric Dyer. Building steadily here, keeping possession. That's a great interception. And the ball's got away from him. Andres Samaris. Well, it could be a busy man, this manager, because we're hearing that he's been offered the chance to manage the international side on a part-time basis to keep this job.
Yeah, I mean, he's got to think carefully, I think, not because he wants his workload to become too much. And, Both teams suffer, so it's a big decision for him.
Trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas here. He has been pressed there to running the ball out of play. It's a passing game, and my word, they're passing it well here. Andres Samaris, advantage, says the referee for Benfica.
on the cross, blocked well by the defender. Has taken a touch there of the defender. It will be a corner. Using the match or the pre-match opportunity to have a bit of a dig at his own players.
Yeah, he's gone for it big time. But if it doesn't pay off, I think he'll...
The shot's up! Well, these conditions can be very difficult for defenders, but also for strikers as well. It looks as though the pitch got the better of him.
Yeah, and I don't know about whether he's chosen the right studs, because he seemed to slip as he went to hit the ball there.
Stage, it really is an exciting prospect over the next few months to see how this Champions Cup develops, whether it's the sides that have traditionally done well or some of the newcomers.
Well, it's such a high standard, this football. Many would argue it's higher than international football, particularly when you get towards the end of this competition. No room for error at all.
Jansen, good challenge here. Well here.
Son! He's kept it out.
Well, here's a chance to get their noses in front from the corner. Forward the wall.
Referee's got the card out here for the offender.
Well, he shouldn't get booked for that. Lack of discipline.
I think there'll be plenty of time added on. There should be plenty of time added on, because this is time wasting.
Well, the home team manager is furiously pointing to his watch. So it'll be interesting to see how much stoppage time is played.
For that first goal. Well, the word average comes to mind about his first half. What do you think, Alan?
The opposition defence have marshalled him expertly so far. No chances really for the lad.
It's a change here, and I think it might be a tactical one. This first match of the Champions Cup has taken shape in the first half. Second half underway.
Yeah, match day one, you always want to get off to a good start, so it's a chance for both teams here.
It's good play until they got that challenge in. It's looking good, this move.
Safety first there.
Throw for Tottenham. Danny Rose. Player right at him, but he's kept the ball well on the attack here.
And he's shut off now.
Super goal here. And a super time to get it because they're in front now. Ended up in the back of the net, quite high up too.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether we actually meant it just to go under the bar. Maybe we'll find out afterwards.
To wait a while to get the first goal of the game. He sensed it was coming, it's finally arrived. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. So many riches now for the Premier League clubs in England with the lucrative television deal, and Arsenal have spent some of their incoming money. It's outgoing on this player.
Well, he'll certainly be happy with it. And I think maybe the buying club will too, because £40 million, around that figure anyway, seems a reasonable price for somebody of his quality.
Good forward play from them. Jonas. Samaris. Well, that's not so much an interception as a poor pass. The home team about to make a change.
Song.
Onto the attack now. A timely challenge. Good play. But they've lost the ball now. The opposition can get at them.
Song.
It's a good way to nick the ball back. Quick thinking. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. Didn't expect. Substitution for Spurs coming up. Just a little nudge to nudge you in the direction of what's coming up on EA Sports for you. Our coverage, and he could get away here. With an interception. Makes a challenge here. Dele Alli. And it's with Luisa. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. The countdown is to 10 minutes left. Shizuoka. Still 1-0 here, with the time almost up. What about this impacting on their next game?
Yeah, Spurs go up against Sunderland after this. Certainly not hit the heights.
Chance! He's kept it out. Well, they're a goal up. Now they've got a corner here. Thank you.
opportunity now.
What a lovely death finish that was.
He didn't need any power, really, just enough to roll it past the goalkeeper because the placement was so good.
I think you're going to be playing with an awful lot of confidence to try that, and he is.
Widen the margin here to 2-0.
Number 17,
Eduardo Salvia. It's Harry Winks.
The fourth official
ball shows
three
added minutes. This attack has a bit of menace to it. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. And the ball knocked away long. Here's Ali. Victory for Tottenham Hotspur. And there is the final whistle to confirm that they've won, and they've won the hard way, fought right from first whistle to last, and they've got their reward.
It's a huge boost to beat what is a really good team, and I'm sure the manager in the dressing room will be emphasising that now.
Some final thoughts on one of the better performers today, Alan.
Oh, lots of energy, lots of quality, and a good goal, along with plenty of chances.